Hi there, my name is Connor. I'm a reliability engineer at O1 Labs, where we're developing the Coda protocol. Today I'm going to be showing you how to set up a Coda daemon on Google Cloud. There's a free trial, it's really easy to get set up, and if you don't use Google Cloud, don't worry, we'll be releasing more guides in the future. Okay, let's get started. The first thing you're going to do is navigate to cloud.google.com and log into their cloud console. Then you're going to navigate to Compute Engine, VM Instances, and here's where you're going to sign up for a free trial. The thing I'll note is that you get $300 in credit for free. With that, you can run your Coda daemon or any other project that you might be working on. I'm not going to do that because I have a Google Cloud account, but this is where you'd sign up. Once you get Compute Engine activated, the next thing you're going to do is create a VM instance. On this form, we're going to fill out a couple things like the instance name. We're going to pick a region that's nearby. We're going to select a instance type that is big enough to run the Coda daemon. In this case, I'm going to run N1 Standard 4. And we're going to select an operating system that is compatible with Coda. In this case, I'm going to use Ubuntu 18.04. And I'm going to set a boot disk of 25 gigs. The last thing that we'll do is add a networking tag. You're going to do that by expanding this Management Security Disk Networking Sole Tenancy tab. You're going to click Networking and type in a tag. In this case, I'm going to choose Coda daemon. This becomes really important later when we're opening our firewall rules. The last thing I'll mention is in the security tab, if you'd like to set up remote access via SSH, you can add an SSH public key here. If you don't know what that is, don't worry about it. Google has a really cool way of dealing with remote access. So without further ado, let's click create. As we can see, our VM instance has been created. And the last configuration step that we need to do is create a firewall rule. So we're going to come over here to this menu, scroll down, find VPC network, firewall rules. And we're going to click create firewall rule. On this page, we're going to specify our firewall rule. First, let's enter a name. We're going to make sure that the direction of traffic is ingress. These are external nodes trying to connect to our node. We're going to type in that network tag that we specified earlier. That was Coda daemon. Here, we're going to specify which IP addresses we should allow. In this case, it's just any old IP address on the internet. And here we're going to specify TCP and UDP ports. If you look somewhere here, those ports that you should type in will be there. And once you're done typing in those ports, you can go ahead and click create. Now that we're done creating our firewall rule, we're going to navigate back to our VM instances, and we're going to SSH to the machine. If you set up an SSH public key earlier, you can use your own terminal as you feel comfortable, or you can use the Google Cloud console. This just takes a second. Don't worry about it. Go get a coffee, come back, and you'll be connected. Once you have a shell in the VM, we're going to go back to codaprotocol.com. We're going to click Docs, Getting Started, and scroll down to the Ubuntu 18.04 setup instructions. Since we don't have a previous Coda version installed, we're not going to worry about these steps, and we're just going to copy these directly into our terminal. This last one installs the Coda daemon. Now that our install command is finished, we can check to see if Coda is there. Great, it is. And we can see the list of commands. We're going to go back to codaprotocol.org, back to the docs, click My First Transaction, and we're going to copy and paste this command into our terminal. Click Enter, and the daemon starts up. This will take a couple seconds to boot. It'll bootstrap, it'll connect to peers, and eventually you'll be synced. Okay, if you made it this far, thank you so much for following along. This has been a very simple instruction on how to run a Coda node. If you'd like to learn more about our test nets or challenges or running Coda in production, check out the links in the description. If you have any problems or need help, join our Discord. The link is above. Thanks and have a good one.